made me joyful in your house of prayer. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. Joyful in your house of prayer. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. Lord, you made me joyful in your house of prayer. Oh, you made me joyful in your house of prayer. Lord, you made me joyful in your house of prayer. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. Oh, you made me joyful in your house of prayer. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. Joyful in your house of prayer. Oh Lord, you made me joyful in your house of prayer. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. Oh, you made me joyful in your house of prayer. Would you make me joyful in your house of prayer? You made me joyful in your house of prayer. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. Joyful in your house of prayer. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. I enter in with joy. I enter in with faith. I enter in with joy. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. I enter in with faith. I enter in with. joyful in your house to pray. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. But you made me joyful in your house of prayer. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. So I enter in with joy. Joyful in your house, pray. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. Oh, you made me joyful in your house of prayer. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. Joyful in your house of prayer, Lord Jesus. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. You made me joyful in your house, pray. You made me joyful in your house, pray. Oh, so I enter in with joy. I enter in with faith. I enter in with gladness. praise. Oh, I'll enter in with joy. I enter in with thanks. I enter in with gladness. And I enter in with praise. Oh, I enter in with joy. Joyful offering for my King. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering for my King. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering of praise. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering of thanksgiving. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering for my King. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering of thanksgiving. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering for my King. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering of thanksgiving. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering for my King. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering of thanksgiving. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering for my King. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering of thanksgiving. Woo! Oh, a joyful, joyful offering for my King. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering of thanksgiving. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering for my. A joyful, joyful offering of thanksgiving. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering for my. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering of thanksgiving. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering for my. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering of thanksgiving. Joyful offering of thanksgiving. Oh, joyful, joyful offering for my King. A joyful, joyful offering of thanksgiving. Joyful, joyful offering of thanksgiving. A joyful, joyful offering for my King. Oh, joyful, joyful offering of thanksgiving. Oh, joyful, joyful offering for you, my King. Oh, joyful, joyful offering of thanksgiving. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering for you, my King. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering of thanksgiving. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering for you, my King. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering of thanksgiving. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering for you, my King. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering of thanksgiving. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering for you, my King. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering of thanksgiving. Oh, joyful, joyful offering of thanksgiving. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering of thanksgiving. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering to you, my. Oh, a joyful, joyful offering of thanksgiving. Joyful in your house of prayer. You made me joyful in your house of praise. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. You made me joyful in your house of praise. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. Oh Lord, you made me joyful in your house of praise. You made me joyful in your house of prayer. Lord, you made me joyful in your house of prayer. Oh, you made me joyful in your house of prayer. And I'm living here and dwelling here in this perfect love. I'm living here and dwelling here in this perfect love. Oh, I'm living here and dwelling here in this perfect love of Jesus. And I'm living here and dwelling here in this perfect love. Oh, I'm living here and dwelling. Perfect love. Oh, I'm living here and dwelling here in this perfect love. love. Oh, a perfect 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 love. So I'm living here and dwelling here in this perfect love. Oh, I'm living here and dwelling here in this perfect love. Oh, I'm living here and dwelling here in this perfect love. Oh, Jesus. Oh, I'm living here and dwelling here in this perfect love. Oh, I'm living here and dwelling here. washing of your love, Lord. Forever I will sing you. Forever I will sing of your love. In the morning, in the evening, and at noon, oh Lord, in worship and praise. In adoration to you,
to pray. We shout to pray. We shout.
nations. We will sing of all your goodness and of your greatness, Lord. We will sing of all your wonders and declare among the nations all the glory of your presence, all the glory of your goodness, all the glory of your grace. Sing of all your wonders and declare your deeds among the nation. Of your greatness, of your greatness, Lord. Joy, we worship. With shouts of praise, with shouts of joy, we worship. Oh, for a perfect love. What perfect love, oh, 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 the love of my Savior, oh, the love of Christ Jesus. Dwelling here in this perfect love. Oh, I'm living here and dwelling here in this perfect love of Jesus. Oh, yes, I'm living here and dwelling here in this perfect love. Oh, I'm living here. Dwelling here in this perfect love. Oh, I'm living here, dwelling here in this perfect love of Jesus. Oh, I'm living here and dwelling here in this perfect love. Oh, I'm living here and dwelling here in this perfect. This perfect love. Oh, I'm living here and dwelling here in this perfect love. Oh, I'm living here and dwelling here in this perfect love. Oh, I'm living here. Dwelling here in this perfect love, And I'm not going out, not going out, not going out, not going out, not going out of your presence. Oh, of your presence. Oh, I'm not going out, not going out, not going out, not going out, not going out of your presence. Your beautiful presence. Of your beautiful presence. Of your glory. Oh, I'm not going out, not going out, not going out, not going out, not going out of your presence, of your presence. Oh, I'm not going out, not going out, not going out, not going out, not going out of your presence. Oh, for in your presence is fullness of joy. Is life and peace in your presence, is fullness of joy in your presence. All I need, oh, in your presence, is fullness of joy in your presence. Life and peace in your presence, is fullness of joy in your presence. All I need. Nothing like your glory, nothing like your presence. Holy, holy Lord, holy, 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 holy is your name. Oh, holy, holy, holy are you, Lord. Holy, holy, holy are your ways. And holy, holy, holy are your people. And I'm one of them. You made it so. Oh, and in your presence is fullness of joy. In your presence is life and peace. In your presence is fullness of joy. In your presence is all I need. Oh, in your presence is fullness of joy. In your presence is life and peace. In your presence is fullness of joy. In your presence is all I need. Oh, I'm not going out, 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 not going out of your presence. Oh, I'm not going out, not going out, not going out, not going out, not going out of your presence, of your beautiful presence, of your beautiful presence, of your glorious presence. Oh, no, I'm not going out, not going out, not going out, not going out, not going out of your presence, of your presence. Oh, no, I'm not going out, not going out, not going out, not going out, not going out of your presence. Oh, for in your presence is fullness of joy, in your presence. Life and peace in your presence is fullness of joy. In your presence is all I need. Oh, in your presence is fullness of joy. In your presence is life and peace. In your presence is fullness of joy. In your presence is all I is fullness of joy. In your presence is life and peace. In your presence is fullness of joy. In your presence is all I need. In your presence is fullness of joy. In your presence is all I need. In your presence is fullness of joy. In your presence is all I need. Lord, senses, fullness of joy. In your presence is life and peace. In your presence is fullness of joy. In your presence is all I need. In your presence is fullness of joy. In your presence is life and peace. In your presence is fullness of joy. In your presence is all I need. Of joy. In your presence is life and peace. In your presence is fullness of joy. In your presence is all I need. Oh, in your presence is fullness of joy. In your presence is life and peace. In your presence is fullness of joy. In your presence is all I need, Lord Jesus. And I am overwhelmed by all of your goodness. But I am overwhelmed by the glory of your presence. But I am overwhelmed by all of your goodness. But I am overwhelmed by the glory of your presence. Oh, I am overwhelmed by all of your goodness. But I am overwhelmed by the glory of your presence. Lord said to my Lord, sit in my right hand till I make your enemies my footstool. Oh, the Lord said to my Lord, sit in my right hand till I make your enemies my footstool. Judge of all the earth, King of righteousness, glorious God and Savior, everlasting one, we worship you. Oh, you have triumphed over all. Oh, you have triumphed over all. Victorious victor, Jesus Christ, King of kings and Lord of lords. You made all things new. righteousness, Lord, our righteousness. You're the Lord, our righteousness. The Lord, our righteousness. You're the Lord, our righteousness. The Lord, our righteousness. You're the Lord, our righteousness. The Lord, our righteousness. You made all things new. Precious blood of Jesus. You made all things new. Lord, you made all things new. Lord, you made all things new. How glorious that you made all things new. Lord, 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 you made all things new by your precious blood poured out. Precious blood poured out. Precious blood poured out. Lord, you made all things new. Lord, you made all things new. Lord, you made all things new. To now say, I have overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of my testimony. By the blood of the Lamb and the word of my testimony. Oh, by the blood of the Lamb and the word of my testimony. Oh, by the blood of the Lamb and the word of my testimony. Oh, by the blood of the Lamb and the word of my testimony. Only by the blood. Oh, by the blood of the Lamb and by my testimony. By the blood of the Lamb and by the word of the testimony. I have overcome just as you will overcame. You made it so, Christ Jesus, by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of my testimony, Jesus. Oh, by the blood of the Lamb, by the word of my testimony, Jesus. Oh, by the blood of the Lamb and the word of my testimony. By the blood of the Lamb, by the word of the testimony, Jesus. By the blood of the Lamb and the word of my testimony. Oh, by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of my testimony, Jesus. One name, only one name, Jesus. Oh, by the blood of the Lamb and the word of my testimony, I have overcome, just as you overcame. For I am found in you, Christ, he lives in me. Oh, Christ, he lives in me. Testimony, Jesus, by the blood of the Lamb and the word of my testimony, Jesus, by the blood of the Lamb and the word of my testimony, Jesus, only Jesus, only Jesus, only Jesus, the true and living way. Jesus, the truth, the life, the way. Jesus, the truth, the life, the way. Jesus, you're the truth, the life, the way. Jesus. Truth, the life, the way. Lord Jesus, the truth, the life, the way. Lord Jesus, the truth, the life, the way. Oh Jesus, the truth, the life. Testimony, Jesus, by the blood of the Lamb and the word of my testimony, Jesus, only by Jesus, all because of Jesus, Jesus, the truth, the life, the way. Oh, Jesus, the truth, the life, the way. Oh, Jesus, the truth, the life, the way. How we love you, Jesus. How we love you, Jesus. Shores of glory. Oh, when I'm finally at my final home. Oh, I will sing of my Savior. Oh, I will sing of you, Lord, and all you've done. By the blood of the Lamb, by the word of my testimony, I have overcome. Only by the blood. Jesus, the truth, the life, the way. Oh, Jesus, the truth, the life, the way. Jesus, the truth, the life, the way. Thank you. sing and saints, the name by which we've been redeemed. The name of the Savior, the Lord, the King of Kings. Jesus, 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 Jesus.
Jesus.
will shine and wonder, healing in your name, Lord Jesus, Lord Jesus, Lord Jesus, highly exalted, forever exalted, Jesus, will shine and wonders, healing in your name, oh Lord Jesus, will shine and wonders, healing in your name, Jesus, will salvation in your name, miracles in your name, signs and wonders by your name, Lord Jesus. Signs and wonders and healing in your name, Jesus. Oh, signs and wonders, healing in your name, by the name, by the name, Jesus, by the name of Jesus, all authority over dominion, signs and wonders, healing in your name, miracles, miracles, miracles by your name, Lord Jesus. Oh, for you possess all heaven, you possess all earth, it's all yours, God. It's all yours, Lord. And signs and wonders and healing in your name, Lord Jesus. Oh, signs and wonders, healing in your name, Lord Jesus. By faith in your name, by holy trusting in your name, Lord Jesus, with signs and wonders in your name. With signs and wonders, healing in your name, Lord Jesus. Isn't it amazing that he purchased it to me? That he already purchased my healing. Oh, he cleansed all my iniquities and healed all my diseases. A finished work of Christ. A finished work of the cross. Salvation brought to me. Signs and wonders, healing in your name. Oh Lord Jesus, signs and wonders, healing in your name. All we could ever need, more than enough. If you need a miracle in your body tonight, just reach out into the realms of faith. Only believe. Oh, for he has already done it. He is more than able, more than enough. The supply, the abundant. Jesus, the Savior, Redeemer, Salvation, Rescuer, Redeemer, Healer, Miracle Worker, signs and wonders, healing in your name. Just proclaim his name tonight. Sing it out deeper than you ever have. Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, sovereign Lord, Jesus, most high God, Jesus, no higher, no greater one, no other name, no other solution, no other remedy, no other way but Jesus. Only Jesus, see, only Jesus tonight. We see only you, Jesus. We choose to see only you, Jesus. Hungry for only you, Jesus. Oh, and signs and wonders, healing in your name. Oh, faith alone in that name. The body that was broken and bruised and crushed to deliver and set free from every bondage of sin, every bondage of disease. Oh, the blood that poured out. Oh, the flesh that was torn to bring healing, to bring the remedy, to bring the supply of the gift of God. Physically, spiritually, every part, body, soul, and spirit, completely, complete by Jesus. Sing it with me just a couple more times. Signs and wonders, healing in your name, and only your name, oh Jesus, and only your name, most high, oh signs and only in that precious name, only in that sacred name, Jesus, Lord Jesus. Oh, signs and wonders, healing in your name, oh Jesus, oh Lord Jesus. Signs and wonders, healing in your name. All I could ever need, supplied before I need it. And I receive it. Again, I petition you, whatever your need is, whatever you have presented before the Lord, just receive it, for He's more than enough. He's more than able. He's the El Shaddai. He is the abundant life. He purchased life.
And I pray that he's made alive on the inside of every person in this place tonight, so that you can live the abundant, joyful, righteous life of God. The gift of God so sweet. Oh, the gift of God so free. So free, so free. Sing this with me. I'm free. Oh, I'm free. So free. Oh, I'm free. I'm free. Free from sin. Free from disease. Free from anything unlike him. Free from sin. Free from disease. Free from everything unlike him. Made whole. Completely complete in Christ Jesus. Oh, this is a faith. For I've been crucified. My life has been, is over. It's dead. And I've been raised up together with him. I've been raised up together with him. Sing this with me. I've been raised up together with him to newness of life. Here we go. I've been raised up together with him. I've been raised up together with Jesus. I've been raised up together with him. Newness of life. In newness of life. I've been raised up together with him. I've been raised up together with him. I've been raised up together with him. In newness of life. Oh, the old is gone. The new is come. Oh, I'm dead to sin, but alive to God in the righteousness. I'm a possessor of the divine nature. A possessor of the gift of God. Righteousness and holiness. A tender heart. A heart of flesh. And he's written his laws in my heart and in my mind, so that I by nature do that which pleases him. So that I say I delight, as the psalmist says in Psalm 45, I delight to do your will, O God. Oh, it's written on me. Oh, the volume of the book is written on me, of Christ Jesus, and I'm in Christ, made alive in him, inseparable, united, not divided, only union, only oneness, only communion, fellowship so sweet. Oh, somebody give a shout of praise. Hallelujah. Oh, just worship with me a little bit longer. I'm a worshiper. That's what I'm going to do forever and eternity. It's what God placed on the inside of me, out of a grateful, thankful heart, realizing how what he brought me out of, that he brought me out of darkness into newness of life. Oh, that I'll set my affections on things above. Oh, for my life is hid, no longer mine, but yours. When signs and wonders, healing in your name, Lord Jesus. With signs and wonders, healing in your name. For by the realms of faith, Lord, you make the impossible possible. You who framed the ages spoke the whole world by the word of your mouth. Who can make something out of nothing? You who alone possess the authority and the ability to do so. The one in charge of everything, the sovereign Lord. We say we agree with you, Lord. We agree with you. We agree only with you. We don't agree with what we see with our natural eyes. We only agree with what we see by your Spirit. And we thank you that you've opened up our eyes to see, and that you've opened up our ears to hear, so that we might see you, Jesus, so that we might see you, Father. And just as you, Lord Jesus, said, I only do that which I see the Father do, we can say boldly with confidence, we do what we see you do, Father. We imitate you, that we be imitators of God, that we follow wholly and only after you, Lord. And we agree only with the reality of truth of your word. The reality of the risen Savior who conquered death, hell, and the grave, ascended up on high, led captivity captive, spoiled everything else, made an absolute ruin out of them, to where they have no more dominion, to where death has no more dominion. Death has lost its sting. That life now reigns by Jesus. That life now reigns. And I speak life to every person here. I speak life in Jesus' name. I speak healing in Jesus' name. Oh, the resurrection power. The resurrection power of Christ Jesus. Imparted, received into every life here tonight. In the name of Jesus. In the name and by the blood of Jesus. With signs and wonders, healing in your name alone, Lord Jesus. Sing this with me just a couple more times, huh? With signs and wonders, healing in your name, Lord Jesus. Only in your name, Lord Jesus. Only in your name, only by the power of your name, Jesus, 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 Jesus. Just begin to join with me in a spiritual song here. Oh, we will sing in the Spirit, and we will sing in the understanding also. For Holy Spirit, all we want is you and your ways in your church. Beautiful glories come. Oh, the realms of the Holy Spirit, and signs and wonders, healing in your name, Lord Jesus. Signs and wonders, healing in your name. Oh, glorious realms of God, glory of heaven, fill this place. Holy Ghost conviction reign. Holy Ghost conviction overwhelm every heart, every life. You're all we seek, Father. You're all we seek, Lord. Well, welcome tonight. I could keep singing this same phrase forever. In fact, one word, Jesus. I could keep going for a couple hours here, but I'm just going to welcome you. I'm going to break here and welcome every person in this place. We're so thankful that you are here. Those who stand by night in the house of the Lord. Those who lift up holy hands in the sanctuary and come bless the Lord. Those who honor the Lord with the offering of praise, with the offering of thanksgiving, with the offering of their life, with the offering of the gathering together as a corporate body of many members joined together as one under the control of Christ Jesus. The one body, one faith, one Lord, one Spirit, one government, one dominion that lasts forever, one King, one Sovereign, one Savior, Jesus. And the privilege that we get to rule and reign with Him forever, to be His servants. Oh, the beauty of your splendor, Lord. Oh, the beauty of your ways. We value your ways, Lord. We value your presence. We value your anointing, Lord. We value the glory of your presence. Well, again, welcome tonight. I'm having an amazing time up here. I hope I'm not the only one. I don't know about you, but I feel the presence of the Lord. It's so beautiful. So beautiful. Yula tukishayetetba. Yula lapacha tukishay. Yula bachashi. Oh, the man I love and say, I'm a man in the ashevupachi. Yehovah's salvation, Christ Jesus. Spotless lamb. The final authority. The finished work. There's a recurrent theme that I'm on here tonight. And I just pray that it always be the one theme forever when I minister, stand, and represent God, and that is Jesus. Jesus. Jesus, it's what we want every song to be about, every prayer to be about, everything we talk to be about, everything of our life to show forth. Jesus, what He's done. Oh, what great things You've done, Lord. Oh, what great things, magnificent God. Words cannot describe the beauty of the depths of the riches of the wisdom and the knowledge of God. Eternal. Infinite. Marvelous. Oh, that men would praise the Lord for His wonderful works on the children of men. Oh, I pray that everyone tonight has a fresh revelation of the wonderful works of Christ Jesus, for the wonderful work He's done for you, of the wonderful things He has for you, of the wonderful plan He has for you, so that you no longer have any excuses. No more excuses. We're going to begin tonight to touch just briefly on Luke chapter 14. If you turn with me there, you can stand up. You can keep singing. You can shout Jesus. You can offer any type of praise. You can jump off the balcony, bounce off the walls. You know, we've been encouraging the youth in that a couple of the past worship nights. I know a lot of you hear me say this quite a bit, but just the extravagance of worship. And can you even imagine what worship's going to look like in heaven? And stepping into a demonstration of that here on earth, that's such a glory glow of heaven, such such a purity, such a Holy Ghost thing, but so extravagant and just amazing. It's what I'm going after, the realms of glory. If you could see sometimes what my spirit feels like, sure many of you can bear witness with this about, like, it's just like an explosion. You know, it's so amazing. You know, just as Jesus says, let the dead bury the dead, and you know, only the living can praise him, the rhetorical question of, could you be mistaken for someone who's dead or nigh death, you know, just barely able to stand still in the presence of God, when in his presence is fullness of joy. Fullness of joy. What does that look like? I mean, come on. What does that look like? Wow. It's the most joyful time you've ever had. Unfortunately, a lot of times we can only compare it to, like, when you got something really good, like a gift that was just what you always wanted or something. But it's way beyond that. Just the goodness of God. And praise the Lord, he's opened up our eyes to see and our ears to hear. So we're going to begin just briefly to dive into Luke 14. There's so much here within this chapter, but I'm going to do my best to just get down to a part of the excuses that we often make when the Lord invites us to his table. And there's a couple dimensions and applications that this could be applied to the end times, right, to the separation of the righteous from the unrighteous, the just, the unjust, the reality of heaven and the reality of hell, but this also the speaking to how often can it possibly be where we make excuses not to, I'm going to break it down, not to come to the Wednesday night meeting, not to the, let's say, the Monday afternoon prayer. Maybe that's a good one. Maybe Friday afternoon. I don't know. For praise God, that's not the case for many of us, but the point I'm trying to make is whatever hour it would be that would try to lure you away where you could try to excuse yourself and justify yourself from sitting at the master's table in communion with him and just the glorious fellowship that he purchased for us to live in. And let's begin here in verse 1. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for your moving, for the revelation that you alone bring of your word as it goes forth out of the mouth of your servant. And it came to pass as he went into the house of one of the chief Pharisees to eat bread on the Sabbath day that they watched him. And behold, there was a certain man before him which had the dropsy. Dropsy was some kind of ailment or condition that obviously he needed healing, as we will see in the proceeding here. And Jesus answering spake unto the lawyers and Pharisees, saying, is it lawful to heal on the Sabbath day? And they held their peace. And he took him and healed him and let him go. And he answered them, saying, which of you that has a donkey or an ox that falls in a pit will not straightway pull him out on the Sabbath day? And they could not answer him again to these things. Again, another example here where the Pharisees, those who thought they had everything right, they were justified in their own eyes, that it made them blind and they could not see, that they were looking to try and, you know, find fault somewhere where they could justify their position. And remember what Jesus says in Matthew, it's escaping me which the chapter is. I think it's in one of the 20s, maybe 22 or something like. Or no, I think it's in the 15 or something. But the that they neglected the weightier matters of the law, mercy, judgment, and faith. 23, thank you. The weightier matters of the law. And what are those again? The weightier matters of the law? Yeah. Mercy, judgment, and faith, as it says there in Matthew. Mercy, judgment, and faith. Mercy, judgment, and faith. And the mercy, the love, that didn't want to leave this man with the dropsy. Sorry, that word makes me laugh. The dropsy. The elements. He needed healing. And Jesus, whatever, who knows, maybe it was just a minor case of it. Anyway, Jesus heals him. But the love of the Savior, the weightier matters of the law, mercy, judgment, and faith. Mercy, judgment, and faith. And may that resound with the echoes of the sermon that Pastor Mark preached last Sunday of the mercy seat. How the judge of all is seated on the mercy seat, and on both sides of him are the cherubims. I love the pastor, way Pastor Mark put it. The cherubims whose face reveal, I'm going to kill you. And, you know, the speaking back to the garden, you can't come near the severity of revealing almost the wrath of God against sin. But Father God seated on the mercy seat. And all that was revealed in that sermon, and if you didn't hear it, please go back and listen to it several times. Mercy, the weightier matters of the law, mercy, judgment, and faith. I'm going to keep going on here because I haven't got to the excuses part. So Jesus is going to give us another pearl of wisdom here in this parable that he reveals. And he put forth a parable to those, this is verse 7. And he put forth a parable to those which were bidden, when he marked how they chose out the chief room, saying unto them, when you are bidden of any man to a wedding, sit not down in the highest room, lest a more honorable man than you be bidden of him. And he that bade thee, and him come and say to thee, give this man place. I love reading the King James. It just has an extra Elizabethan flow to it. And thou begin with shame to take the lowest room. When thou art bidden, go and sit down in the lowest room, that when he that bade thee cometh, he may say unto you, friend, go up higher. Then shall you have worship in the presence of them that sit at meat with thee. For whosoever exalteth himself shall be abased, and he that humbleth himself shall be exalted. Again, manifest in the ways of the kingdom that are right side up. They're contrary to the ways of men. That echoes, as it said before, about the first shall be last and the last shall be first. A complete opposite of the way we're taught about how we think things are to be or are. When we must, our lives line up with the kingdom of God operation, the kingdom of God way. Verse 12, and here's yet another exhortation. Then said he also to him that bade him, when you make a dinner or supper, call not your friends, nor your brethren, nor your kinsmen, nor your rich neighbors, lest they also bid you again and recompense be made thee. Right, calling those people that could then, you know, almost as it is, pay you back. I invite you over for supper, so you invite me over to your party. But check this out. When's the last time we did this? But when you make a feast, call the poor, the maimed, the lame, the blind. Do you hear the resounding of the weightier matters of the law? Mercy, judgment, and faith. Mercy, love, love. That reaches out to the poor. That reaches out to the maimed, the lame, the blind, both physically and spiritually. That gives them the feast. That gives them the food they need. That gives them the remedy. Jesus. Jesus. and you shall be blessed. For they cannot recompense thee. They can't pay you back. For you shall be recompensed at the resurrection of the just. Wow. The resurrection of the just. The day in the realms of the eternity. In the kingdom of heaven. Wow. Can you even begin to think about the glory of that? That these present things can't even begin to compare to the glory of the realm of the kingdom of God. The kingdom of the sovereign, the kingdom of the I am, the kingdom of the almighty, the everlasting kingdom of the most high God, who made you and me, who created the earth and the sea, everything around, from the trees to the ground, from the sky, the hills, everything, stars. What an awesome God. What an awesome God. Awesome. Verse 15, and when one of them sat at meat with heard these things, he said to him, blessed is he that shall eat bread in the kingdom of God. Check this out. Again, I'm taking a little liberty with this, but sometimes it's just, you know, you're reading along here, and then all of a sudden, some guy who's one of them that's sitting there hearing this sayings all of a sudden lets out and utters the phrase, blessed is he that shall eat bread in the kingdom of God, which is true, right? I mean, that is a pretty amazing thing. But look what Jesus then says. Then he said unto them, he tells them about this. A certain man made a great supper and bade many. Verse 17. And sent his servant at supper time to say to them that were bidden, come, come, for all things are now ready. And they all with one consent began to make excuse. Check out these excuses. Check them out. Let's see how powerful these are. Let's see if we can maybe reason to find a valid excuse here. And in examining and searching here, see if it sounds like anything we're doing of making excuses. Say this with me real quick. Say, no excuses. I have no right to make an excuse. The time is too short. The need is too great. So no excuses. No excuses. Here's the first one. The verse said unto him, I bought a piece of ground and I must needs go and see it. Time out. I mean, as I read this literally, he said, I bought a piece of ground and I must needs go and see it. Now, I haven't studied this passage in depth at all. But what I get from that, this guy's excuse is he bought something and he says, I need to go and see it. And something doesn't click for me. Wait, didn't he already see it? So that's why he bought it, because he saw it and liked it? Or since he bought it and it was already his, he was the possessor, purchaser, couldn't he have just waited to see it? Doesn't that make sense? Excuse one. Wow. Something that he could have done perhaps at another time. Now, in our excuses of why we don't come to the supper, again, there's a couple parallels that this speaks to, but for right now, I'm bringing it right to where we are. Of it, sitting at the table of the Lord, sitting in communion, sitting in fellowship, sitting and doing and executing the will of our Father. You guys can keep playing. You don't have to stop. Unless you're tired. No excuses. See what? I just started making excuse there. Why? You got to watch out. Oh, I'm tired. I've been standing for over an hour. Worship went really long tonight. Brother Joshua just likes to worship. Man, it's kind of hard on the legs and the body. I feel fatigued. It's like a marathon. Excuses. Thank you for that example. Praise God. And again, I just want to encourage you guys, this isn't something that I sat down and began to just scribe out, oh, I wonder what parallel I could present this evening to you. But no, just a flow as the Holy Ghost is speaking through me tonight about the excuses. So check this out. It may pop out in a way you haven't heard it before. The first said unto him, I bought a new piece of ground, and I must needs and go see it. Perhaps he could have waited just a little bit, done it another time. How we give account for our life and time. And how important it is for us to make sure it's a command from Jesus. Look how many times in the gospel he says, seek the kingdom first. He that doesn't take up his cross is not worthy of me. We're going to see it here later. This is what Jesus told us. It's like, wow. You, there's no wiggle room out of that. It's recorded several times in the Gospels that's corroborated, that's what Jesus said. Whoa, where's the room for excuses now? But anyway, excuse one, I have bought, and bear with me as in the redundancy of this, but I just want to let it sink in. I bought a piece of ground. To me, this is the excuse that just doesn't quite click. I bought a piece of ground, and I must needs go and see it. How trivial sometimes the things that we make the priority and importance of, I got to do this, I got to do that. When in the eyes of eternity, it's of little consequence. May that provoke you, may it provoke me, and how we order and how we seek after, how we go after, how we present ourselves the offering of our lives in order that we might order our lives aright. Kingdom first, and everything else falls beneath that at any moment. Next excuse two. Another said, I have bought 5 yoke of oxen. I go to prove them. I pray thee have the excuse. Excuse me. I pray, again, the Elizabethan here, the King James. I pray thee have me excused. I mean, what does that even mean? I go to prove them. Could that not wait? Did that need to be done right then? Was that really important? 5 oxen? 5 oxen versus the supper? 5 oxen versus the feast? 5 oxen, let me put it versus it this way, the extravagant party? 5 oxen to prove them. It's excuse 2. I pray thee have me excused. Verse 20. Third reason, and the only one here that I can actually relate to and makes a kind of sense to me, to spend time with the wifey. And another said, I've married a wife and therefore I cannot come. So that servant came and showed his Lord these things. Then the master of the house, being angry, I got that phrase highlighted in red, deep red. The master of the house being angry. Remember, this is speaking of the Father, heaven. Oh man, when Father gets angry, watch out. Who? The psalm says, the hills melt like wax at the presence of the Lord. Whoa! Things just rearrange. Tremble, tremble, O earth, at the presence of the God of Jacob. You do not want to be the subject of God's anger. And let me remind you again that the wrath of God burns against sin. And how beautiful it is that he made us to be holy like him. We're so many in this day and age, as we've heard people present it as, it's such a negative thing, it's such a struggle. No, not so. Not the abundant life of Christ Jesus. You need to encounter God. You need to encounter redemption. Hallelujah. The redeemed. I'm redeemed. I'm redeemed. I'm redeemed. Hang with me a little longer. Then the master of the house, being angry, said to his servant, go out quickly into the streets and the lanes of the city and bring in hither the poor, the maimed, the halt, the blind, those unqualified, those who would have not been first choice, those who were not first string, those who you and I would not pick. But because of their excuses, they got left out, moved on. The father was angry because they had a chance. They made an excuse. They chose not to. How lame our excuses can be at times. True? It's so true. I don't know about you, but I could think of times where my excuses were really lame. Lame. Like the first guy's excuse there of, I bought a piece of ground, I must needs go see it. What? Pull it together. Slap yourself and come out of your stupor. Oh, bless God. It's so fun being saved and made alive in Christ Jesus. What a joy. What a fellowship. Bring in the poor. Those who don't have anything. Those who have no self-worth, the maimed, the halt, the blind, those who do not have really anything to offer, those who don't have really anything they can bring, they find no strength in themselves, but their only opportunity is given here. They're invited to come to this party, to this supper. Just before this, we had the parable of the feast made. It's like Jesus sets us up so perfectly, right? Where it makes us, when was the last time when we had a party, a feast, that we invited the poor, the lame, the maimed, right? Not invited the people that can do something nice for us or bring something potluck style to contribute. But then sets us up for this. For the dichotomy here of those beginning at verse 18 that with one consent began to make excuse. I've got to say it one more time. Go out and quickly in the streets and the lanes of the city and bring in hither the poor and the maimed and the halt and the blind, the needy, the desperate. Those busted up who didn't have containment within themselves, they needed help. They needed a Savior, Christ Jesus. just as we were in such need of a Savior. How we were pathetic, a pathetic case, and Christ Jesus came to give us life and life more abundantly. Verse 23, and the Lord said unto the servant, go out in the highways and the hedges and compel them to come, that my house may be filled. For I say unto you that none of those, again, I got this verse 24 highlighted in red. This is connected with the anger of the Father. Look what he says here. For I say unto you that none of those men which were bidden shall taste of my supper. Those that before were called, had excuses. Father says, none of those men shall taste of my supper. And look what Jesus says in the next verse, 25. And there went great multitudes with him, and he turned, and he said unto them, if any man come to me and hate not his father and mother and wife and children and brethren and sisters, yea, and also his life, he cannot be my disciple. Wow. Doesn't that just chop up any excuses? That's what Jesus said. If any man come to me and hate not his father and mother and wife and children and brethren and sisters, yea, in his own life also he cannot be a disciple. But check this out. This isn't some miserable thing that we have to do. There is a realm of love where everything else becomes meaningless, where it can all, where it's almost seemingly effortlessly that you can do this in comparison to the love that you have for Christ Jesus. You know, just to stir you up, I've heard those stories of those who have gone before who were persecuted for the gospel, husbands and wives who were separated, one in particular. I could think of a man thrown in prison who wouldn't even look at his wife who came to visit him because he did not want to be drawn away from his purpose and his first love. Isn't that just powerful? But that realm of love, that compels us, the love of God that compels us to go out into the highways and to the byways and compel them to come, that Father's house may be filled. Another application here, that his house that he has right here in San Diego, the abiding place, may be filled. For we are a church ordained by God. We are a church founded by God, not by the constructs of men. It's been testified again and again. Look at what miracle, from miracle to miracle, provision. Where this place has been presented on the altar that says, God, unless you come through, we cease to exist, and we'll gladly do whatever you have us, Father. But lift up your eyes. Look where we stand. We stand in a large place. A large, large place. Father, may we never make any more excuses. First and foremost, for anything that would compromise our place in you. Father, may we never make any excuses for why we cannot put your kingdom first, for you commanded it to be. And Father, may we never make excuses for why we cannot compel them to come so that your house might be filled, so there might be much fruit, much harvest in your house. Lord, for we know how much you care. The God of mercy, the God of truth, the God of justice, that at just the salvation of one, just a lost sheep, even as the parable of the 100 sheep, the 99 losing one, and how much you rejoice at the salvation of one. Lord, that we never have excuses for why we can't compel them to come, that your house may be filled. That we may never have excuses of why we cannot sit at your supper, attending the party, the Holy Ghost party, the Holy Ghost supper, the Holy Ghost fellowship, this place of communion with you. Verse 27, still Jesus speaking. And whosoever does not bear his cross and come after me cannot be my disciple. Again, no room for excuse. The words of a sermon Pastor Ruth preached several months ago. Have you felt your cross lately? Always comes to mind when I read this verse. Have you felt your cross lately? Yes, his yoke is easy and his burden is light. And there's such a glorious communion. But that doesn't mean we do not have a responsibility to bear our cross, come after him, come after Jesus, and be his disciple. And do not allow any excuse that would get in the way of that. Say it with me again, no excuses. The time is too short. The need is too great. No excuses. Now we're going to get into the counting the cost. The counting the cost. Verse 28. For which of you intending to build a tower sits not down first and counts the cost, whether you're sufficient to finish it? Lest haply after he hath laid the foundation is not able to finish it, and all that behold it begin to mock him, saying, this man began to build and was not able to finish. Or what king going to make war against another king sits not down and consults whether he be able with 10,000 to meet him that cometh against him with 20,000? Or else while the other is yet a great way off, he sendeth an ambassage and desireth conditions of peace. So likewise, whosoever he be of you that forsaketh not all that he has cannot be my disciple. There it is again. Where is the room for excuse there? Whoa, forsakes not all that he has, he cannot be my disciple. So likewise, whosoever, verse 33, so likewise, whosoever he be of you that forsakes not all that he has cannot be my disciple. Salt is good, but the salt has lost its savor. Wherewith shall it be seasoned? It is neither fit for land, nor yet for the dunghill. Woo. But men cast it out. He that hath ears, let him hear. Have you lost your salt because you made excuses? Praise God for his mercy. Praise God for his grace that we're still alive and in this place where we can say, Lord, say this with me, Lord, I will not make excuses. Lord, I will not make excuses. No excuses. No excuses. The time is too short. The need is too great. No excuses. The time is too short. The need is too great. But what's so amazing, let me remind you of how it's not a hard thing. Communion and fellowship is a glorious thing. It's the good life. It's where the fun's at. Participating with heaven and the kingdom of God now. I'd ask that you all stand with me here tonight. Lord, I thank you for everyone who's in this place. Tonight on Wednesday, December 14th, presenting ourselves before you, knowing there is no need, too small or great, there is no need too small or great that you cannot supply. For you are the God of miracles, the God of Abraham, of Isaac, of Jacob, Joseph. You're the God who heals us. You're our deliverer. You're our Savior. You are the Most High God, the everlasting, our shield and exceeding great reward. The one who sees us, the Lord our provider, the judge of all the earth. You are God Most High who possesses heaven and earth. You are the everlasting God. The I am that I am. Merciful. Gracious. Long-suffering. Abundant in goodness. And truth. Your name is forever. You are wonderful. You're the rock of our salvation. You're a consuming fire and a jealous God. And we are your people. And we say you are our God. And the testimony of the Lord stands sure. Forever settled. Forever secure. Jesus, Savior, Redeemer, the Lord our righteousness, King forever. Hallelujah! Lord of hosts, you're enthroned above the cherubim. You are God. You alone made heaven and earth. You're from everlasting to everlasting. The Lord of lords, great, mighty, and fearful. You ride upon the heavens, and we extol your name. Yah. Your name is great and fearful, for it's holy. You're the Lord our maker. You're the one who heals all our diseases and forgives all our iniquities. The Lord our shepherd. Just as we stand in this place tonight, remind you again, whatever you have need of, receive it. For Christ Jesus already purchased it with his precious blood. For the joy set before him, he endured the cross. The punishment for our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. living in a miracle. Living in a miracle. My life is a miracle. A miracle of Christ Jesus. I'm a miracle. A miracle of Christ Jesus. Blood bought, heaven sought, called by God, given a new name, a new place. Place to rule and reign with the Most High God. Lord, you rejoice over us with singing. You rest in your love. How precious are your thoughts towards us. They are more than the sands of the sea. More than we can contain. This infinite love. What infinite love that you love us with, God. Oh, how beautiful. Oh, how beautiful. Oh, how beautiful. How beautiful this love. How beautiful this love. How beautiful this love. How beautiful this love of Christ Jesus. Poured out, freely given. So that many sons might be brought to glory. Beautiful, beautiful love. What beautiful, beautiful love. What beautiful, beautiful love. What glorious, glorious love. What glorious, glorious love. What beautiful, beautiful love. Perfect love. Let His perfect love just fill you. Let His perfect love just overwhelm your being. He's the miracle God who freely gave and freely gives. Wow. Beautiful, beautiful love. Oh, a beautiful, beautiful love. From a glorious, glorious God. From a glorious, glorious God. Oh, a beautiful, beautiful love. Oh, a beautiful, beautiful love from a glorious, glorious God. Oh, a glorious, glorious God. Beautiful, beautiful. All the depths of the riches of His love. Just in this place of worship, just as we've been bringing an offering of praise, we're going to give you an opportunity to bring an offering of your finance, the offering of that which is dear to you. Just as Jesus said, where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. That everyone in this place says, Lord, our treasure is in you, Christ Jesus. Our treasure is in heaven. Our treasure is in the kingdom of God. And not in anything we possess do we find status or purpose, but in you alone, Christ Jesus. So we will bring of our substance. We will bring of the fruit of our increase, the fruit of our ground, the fruit of our labors. And pour it out, you, out on you, Lord, this offering. You guys can begin to come, bring your offering if you purpose to do so, not grudgingly or out of necessity. Oh, for God loves a cheerful giver, those ready to give, those who love and delight in it, who see the beauty of it. I just got to share this. He's not looking for the stingy Scrooge. Of course, the Scrooge person needs to learn how to give. And become Scrooge 2.0. Or something like that. How we love you, Lord. We pour out this offering at your feet. Bring it to you, oh Lord, our King. It's a testament of this life purchased by you. It's a testimony of our all, which we owe to you alone. Father, I ask that you multiply the gifts of every person in this place, that we step into new realms and territories, dimensions of faith, of increase, of multiplication, of the realms of God that is abundant and extravagant God, a God of life and love.
We don't want to be too busy for the Father. The Father's calling us to come. He calls us to come and have audience with the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And so many of us have all of these things that occupy our time. And, you know, this surprise comes up and this person comes in the door and this, the phone rings and this happens. And that time that you were supposed to come and meet with the Father, that time that he was bidding you to come, those distractions, all those kinds of busyness, those things that you will push away the Father to go, to occupy something that is so temporal, that is so temporal upon this earth. We must be desperately hungry for him. Our life must be lost and hid in him, or we're not worthy of him. If we are not salty, if we're not desperately hungry, then we're not salty. And if we're not salty, we're good for nothing but to be cast out and trodden under the foot of men. And that comes in a relationship and a fellowship of desperate hungry that he is first. He's always first. When he bids us, we're coming. We're not excusing ourselves. We're coming. We're running to him, Jesus. And I just had to get on my knees and say, Father, forgive me. Forgive me. Forgive me, Father, for not dropping everything. I mean, you know, just things that are busy about the church. And, you know, we could get wrapped up in a Christmas play. And yes, that's good in its ministry. But you don't want to get so busy and overcommitted with anything, even though you have a commitment. And you want to fulfill it, that Father's not first. There's just so much stuff. There's so much distraction. And if we're salty, we're going to change the earth. We're going to change the people around us. We're going to change the earth. We're going to change the world. And I'm saying, Father, I'm just not doing enough. I don't know if it hit you guys. This message hit you guys like it hit me. But it just, like, it just was, I know it was the Father speaking to us. We're here, right? We're here. And Father was speaking to us. Jesus, we want to be salty. We want to be sensitive. When the Father bids us to come, we want to just drop what we're doing and come into his presence. Forget about the stuff. Forget about these temporal things. They don't matter. And those excuses there were better than the ones we come up with. They were. You know, I know most of, a lot of you know, I got an accident on Saturday and busted my head, and it was just a mess. And I tell you, I woke up Sunday morning and I said, Father, I feel pretty rough. I mean, I felt like I was walking in, I was in a dream, you know, just not quite here. And I'm like, I feel pretty rough, Lord. I don't feel like climbing out of this bed. I just want to lay here. Can I lay here? And do you know what hits me? They left Paul under a pile of stones as he was, as for dead. They left him dead. And he got up, and he went in, and he ministered to the brethren, and he got up the next morning and went on his next journey. I got up out of that bed and went and started trying to wash the blood out of my hair that had been bleeding all through the night. And I got here, whether I looked good or I didn't. He's got to be everything all the time, every moment. He's really saying this to us all the time.
Desperate and I'm needy, desperate and I'm needy for you. Oh, I'm desperate and I'm needy, oh, desperate and I'm needy for you. Desperate and I'm needy for you. Oh, I'm desperate and I'm needy, so desperate and I'm needy for you. Oh, I'm desperate and I'm needy, so desperate and I'm needy for you. Your feet, been waiting on you, Lord, in sweet communion and fellowship with you. Oh, there's nothing more important, there's nothing more important than sitting at your feet, communion with you, Lord. And I'm needing, so desperate, and I'm desperate and I'm needy, so desperate and I'm needy for you. I'm desperate and I'm needy, so desperate and so needy for you, Lord Jesus. Oh, I'm desperate and I'm needy, so desperate and so needy for you. I'm desperate and I'm needy, so desperate and so needy for you. And there's nothing more important, nothing more important than you. Lord, there's nothing more important, nothing more important than you. Nothing, 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 nothing more important, nothing more important than you. Jesus, first love. Thank you. And I'm desperate and I'm needy, so desperate and so needy for you. Oh, I'm desperate and I'm needy, so desperate and so needy for you, Lord. Oh, I'm desperate and I'm needy, so desperate and so needy for you. At your feet, learn of you. Oh, I will sit at your feet and wait on you. Lord, I will sit at your feet and learn of you. Lord, I will sit at your feet and wait on you. There's nothing more important, nothing more important than Jesus. There's nothing more important, nothing more important than Jesus. There's nothing more important, nothing more important than at your feet and learn of you. Lord, I will sit at your feet and wait on you. Lord, I will sit at your feet and learn of you. I will sit at your feet and wait on. There's nothing more important, nothing more important than you, Jesus. Lover of my soul, Savior. There's nothing more important, nothing more important than you, Jesus. Truly, there is nothing more important, nothing more important than you. justify the faith of the Son of God, who loved me, changed me, redeemed me. What love, what grace, what beauty. And there's nothing more important, nothing more important than oh Jesus. Oh, there's nothing more important, nothing more important than Jesus.
Having pain in your back. Grace, come on up here, Grace. Who has pain in their body? Anyone else have pain throughout their body? Someone have a toothache? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Father, we thank you that you're going to drive out.
Signs and wonders.
there's miracles right now. In the name of Jesus, in the name above all names, in the name above all names, the name of Jesus. With signs and wonders and miracles right now, in the name above all names, the name of Jesus. Consider yourself dismissed. Find those around you. Bless them in Jesus' name. Tell them you love them. You can stay as long as you want. We love each and every one of you. Go forth with joy and be led with singing.